No. I'm okay with that. Hello, everyone. As posted, my name is Deslav. I'm here to present you the huge project that Brandon already said a couple of things, but he didn't say what it stands for. So let's start with what it stands for. Hydrogen utilization and green energy is what the acronym stands for. First of all, I want to say a huge thank you to Paul and the NUI Galway team for organizing this seminar in such a short notice. They had maybe less than a month, and they managed to organize it. So huge thank you for all the effort. It's a great turn up, and we have speakers from Iceland, from Norway, from Netherlands. So when I was writing public seminars in the beginning, in the project application actually stage, I wasn't imagining that it's going to be such a success, our first one. So let me tell you just the quick introduction of our institution. So we are leading the project, and we are the Environmental Research Institute. But we're not just that. We're part of the North Highland College, which in itself is part of the University of Highlands and Islands, which is a network of universities, 13 universities, across the Highlands and Islands of Scotland. So you can see the blue part there on the map. We have 13 universities spread across, and we are one of them. Then we have, so this is location. This is where we are actually based. This is the end of the world, as we know it. This is the brink of the world, and just across you can see Orkney on the picture up there. And those are our two campuses. We have the Center for Energy and Environment and our other campus, which is on Castle Street. The research priorities that ERI has put for ourselves, we have renewable energy and environment, which we work under, but we have as well water, carbon, and climate theme, and environmental contamination and ecological health. So Orkney, as I said, the picture before that, where we see it across, is where the, okay, it's not working. The picture before that is where everything started 2 years ago, when we had a seminar, and we had working under another project called GREEP, and the seminar was building a hydrogen economy for Orkney. So this is where the idea for the huge project sparked. And it's been a long way since we came to here, came to actually getting funded. Brendan did a lot of the job for explaining NPA, so I'm not going to go further. It's just I'm going to skip even with the acronym. So NPA, the Northern Periphery and Arctic Program, this is where we get our funding from. We have 1.4 million, and we have across 3 years, across 8 partners. So it's us that are leading the project. We have Action Renewables from Northern Ireland, NUI Galway from Ireland, La Parente University from Finland. We have the University of Faroe Islands, the Highland Council from Scotland, and the Arran Island Energy Co-op, and Icelandic New Energy from Iceland. We have a huge network of associate partners as well that we are very proud with, and we are looking forward to work actually quite tightly with them. And we have, from Scotland, we have Orkney Council that we're going to be working with. Then we have, from Norway, we have SINTEF and NTNU. From Ireland, we have ERVIA, DCU, Energy Cooperatives Ireland, and Northern and Western Regional Assembly as our associate partners. We have ESTE, which is an energy company from Finland. We have 3 associate partners from the Faroe Islands. We have the Energy Association, the Nólsoy Energy Company, and the Municipality of Tórsvatn. We'll see that it is. I will learn how to pronounce it. So we are very happy with our network, partnership network, both main partners and associate partners. And this is something that I made actually while I was doing the project application. I know it's very colorful, but I'm going to continue using it because I think it's very straight forward to explain what we're actually doing. So this is for people that don't have too much experience in interact projects. We have a managerial part of work, and then we have technical work packages. So the management work package and communication is going to be led by us, so we're going to be coordinating the project. And then we have the 3 technical work packages, which will deliver our main outputs. So the first work package is techno-economic assessment, a viable technical process for remote, peripheral, and dispersed hydrogen operations, but this will become very shortly just the T2, so you don't have to remember all of this, which is going to be led by Action Renewables. Then the second work package is creating hydrogen utilization business models led by Lappeenranta University in Finland. And the third technical work package is hydrogen knowledge and technology transfer, which will be led by NUI Galway. So all of those three work packages, as you can see down, so those are the work packages. Then down there you have the tool, the model, and the platform, which will come out from the three technical work packages. So we have the techno-economic assessment tool, the T2, which I'm going to say a little bit after I'm done with this slide. I'm going to tell a little bit for each of them. So we have the T2, the HUB model, and the HTT platform, the only disappointment when it comes to acronyms, all forming the HOT service, which is the Hydrogen Operational Technical Service. So now I'm going to just tell you a little bit for each of them and what we are planning to do, but we welcome any feedback as well, so please do contact us if you have any feedback as to our tools and methods. So we have the T2 led by Action Renewables in Northern Ireland, which main word of it is what we're going for is innovation, because it's comprising of the tool itself comprised of pulling the competences and transnational learning from all the partners that we have in our main partnership and our extended associate partnership network. The design of it will combine process modeling and engineering design with economic evaluation, and obviously it will be made available to the public and everyone across the NTA and further regions as well. And the solution that will come out of the T2, we hope, is going to be the advance of innovative economic development solution for techno-economic assessment of viable processes for hydrogen operations. So this is the first one. The second outcome was the hydrogen utilization and business model, or the HUB model, which we have here. We have transboundary because we believe that by evaluating the renewable energy chain from production through storage, through transport to the end user in a transboundary model where we get experience from all the partners that we have, we will be able to create a transboundary solution. But this solution, I will tell you, so the design of this, it will focus on the value analysis and the ecosystem of hydrogen supply chain in order to develop feasible business model. And the solution is that it will actually build upon the T2 that we'll create in the first technical work package by developing the feasible business model after the techno-economic assessment tool is done. So which basically means that you take, we're going to apply both of the tool and the model into real-life case scenarios. So this is why we have Aran Island, we have Iceland, we have Faroes, and we have the Highland Council as partners, where we're going to take them as case studies and apply the T2 and the HUB model in order to prove that they can actually work. So we're going to explore different solutions. First, we need to have seminars before that with end users and stakeholders in order to decide which is the appropriate solution. But we're looking at maybe complementary gas injections of hydrogen into the gas system, maybe in Scotland. We're obviously looking at marine transport as well, wind to hydrogen. So we'll look at many different solutions. And after we apply them to case scenarios, real-life case scenarios, we will end up having a generic model that can be applied in other scenarios. The last technical work is going to be the knowledge transfer platform, which we're going to be developed by the Center of Excellence here in NUI Galway. And they will use their state of, so here the main word we're looking at is transfer of knowledge, transfer of experiences, transfer even if you want contact. So they're going to be using their state-of-art online learning tools to ensure that training and knowledge is accessible, can be translated to all of our partner regions and beyond the NTA area. And the solution is that it will promote knowledge sharing and information exchange between actors in the hydrogen and renewable energy production sectors. There is no platform that exists up until now, so we'll be innovators in this as well. I've told you how end users and stakeholder integration, this is at the base, at the core of our project is interaction through our project partnership, through our work, to be constantly working with the end users and stakeholders that are going to hopefully take our solutions after that and apply them and continue developing them. So it will be directly created with them. And we have two-phase workshops as well that are going to be, so phase one is going to be until the end of this year. Each of our regions will have a workshop with stakeholders and end users in order to create specific understanding about the needs and the regional context so we can after that apply them in the model and the tool. And after that, we are hoping to have another workshop at the end of the second year, but before the end of the project, so we have time to adjust the tools if they are not working or if they need specific tweaks for different regions. And in the middle of this, we will have also workshops across all of our regions, which will be organized by NUI Galway. There will be knowledge transfer workshops. And this is all from me for now. Thank you very much for having us here. This is the launch of the project, so thank you everyone for coming here. And please follow us on all the social media there.
Thank you, this is Lava. So now we have a set of three speakers that are coming from abroad. So my personal thanks to all of them that have come all the way to Galway. And they are coming to talk about successful examples of hydrogen being used already in the regions. So the first speaker is Jon Bjørn Skulason. He's coming from